This is Sunday School for March the 26th in the year 2023, and it's called The Reunion of the Brothers. As you'll remember, Jacob and Esau were two twin brothers, and Esau was the oldest and Jacob was the younger, and Jacob cheats him out of the birthright, and then he cheats him out of the blessing from the dad, and now he has lived for 20 years with Uncle Laban. And he's headed back to Esau, and he's scared. And in last week's lesson, he was in a wrestling match with God in the middle of the night. And as they were wrestling, Jacob's hip gets pointed out of place. And the angel who was wrestling with him calls him Israel instead of Jacob. He's done with the name Jacob, which means cheater. And now he wakes up in the morning and he looks up and he sees Esau coming with 400 men. And he remembers all the ways that he has cheated his brother. And he thinks, Esau's going to kill me. That's what's going to happen. So he lines up his family. He puts Bilhah and Zilpah in the front with their kids, and then he puts Leah with her kids, and then he puts Rachel, who is pregnant, and Joseph at the very end. And then he runs out in front of his whole family, and he runs up to Esau, and he bows down to the ground 7 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, and then Esau grabs him and hugs him, holds him around the neck, and kisses him, and they both cry. It was wonderful. And then Esau said, who is all these people with you? And Jacob says, this is my family that your servant is coming home with. I am your servant now, Esau. He put himself second. And these are my wives and my children. And then each of the wives went down up and bowed down to Esau. And then all of the children went and bowed down to Esau. And then Esau said, why did you send me all of these animals? And he said, to find favor in your sight. If you're smiling at me and you're welcoming me home, it's like God is just doing a wonderful thing. Like I can see the face of God because you are welcoming me home. And Esau said, you don't need to give me all these animals. There's 100 animals or more here. You don't have to. I have animals of my own. And Jacob says, no, no, no. I want to give this as a gift to you. This is my gift to you. And he says, you don't understand how gracious God was to give me all this family, to give me all these camels and all these sheep and cows. You take it. And so Esau said, all right, I'll take the gift. And then he said, let's go together to my house and we'll travel together and we'll go back to see our dad. And Jacob says, no, 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 we can't do that. The kids will never be able to move very fast. And I have cows with little calves, and I have sheep with baby sheep, and they're still nursing. And we're just gonna have to go really, really slow. You go ahead. And Esau says, okay, then I'll leave some of my men with you, some of my 400 men to help you get there. And Jacob says, no, we'll get there. You go on home and we will catch up with you. And so Esau turned around and went back, and they didn't have a fight at all. And Jacob built himself a house, and he made some booths or some fenced-in areas for all of his animals. And then he built an altar, and he worshiped God. And God said, Jacob, you made me a promise back at Bethel. You need to go back to Bethel. That's the place where the ladder went up to heaven, and the angels were ascending and descending on it. He says, go back to Bethel. So Jacob starts going back to Bethel, and then he thinks about all those foreign gods and all those earrings and nose rings and finger rings, things that represented the gods of Laban. And he dug a big hole, and he told his family and all the servants to put all that false, fake stuff in that hole by a big oak tree. and he covered it up. And I'm sure those people knew where that oak tree was for a long time. And then he goes to Bethel. And he says, God, you are the one that told me you would bring me back safely. And I'm the one that said I would give you a tithe. I would give you 1/10 of everything you give me. And that's what I'm giving you now. And so he made sacrifices to God. And God talked to him again and said, I'm going to give you the land that I promised to Isaac, your dad, and to Abraham, your grandfather. And your name is now Israel. It's not Cheater anymore. And Israel means one who wrestles with God and wins. And then the next thing that happens in the story is Rachel has that new baby, and she names him Benjamin. But she dies when she's having the baby, which is a really sad thing. And the memory verse is the Lord's Prayer. So I would like you to pray it with me. If you don't know it, then that's something you need to start learning at your house. Your parents probably know it well enough that they can pray it with you. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. And we chose that verse because Jacob was willing to forgive. No, Esau was willing to forgive Jacob. Okay? Forgive us our debts, what we owe to someone else, as we forgive our debtors. And if we don't forgive other people, then you can't forgive us. That's the end. Thanks for watching.